This is a programming guide for the TR8100V thermostat. Firstly, let's run through what the symbols represent on the display screen. The padlock symbol means the thermostat's keypad is locked. The flame symbol means the element is switched on at that moment. The frost symbol means that the unit's frost protection system has been activated. The house symbol, with the number inside, represents which programming schedule the unit is using at that time. The hand symbol means the unit is in manual mode, whereby the unit will ignore its timer and follow the temperature you set at that moment. The auto symbol means the unit is operating automatically using its preset timer. The override symbol means the unit is temporarily operating at the temperature you have selected, and it will automatically go back to its scheduled temperature when the next programmed switch on or switch off time occurs. The ERR symbol means the floor sensor has an error and is faulty or not connected properly. The moon symbol means the unit is operating in economy mode. When in economy mode, your floors will only turn on when the temperature falls below your chosen minimum temperature. And the sun symbol means the unit is currently operating in comfort mode. When in comfort mode, the floors will be heated to the temperature you desire. Now, let's move on to programming the thermostat for the first time. Configuring your thermostat. In this section, we will run through the primary configuration settings. You can use your finger or a plastic pointer to keep the display free of fingerprints. To begin configuring your thermostat, make sure the unit is switched off by pressing the power button. Then, press the menu button. Depending on your unit's individual configuration, some of the following menu options on this video may not appear on your thermostat. Menu 1 and the letter A will show. Menu 1 allows you to choose which sensor the unit will use to determine the floor temperature. You can use the up or down arrows to select between A, where the unit will use its built-in air temperature sensor, AF, where the unit will use its air temperature sensor and the floor temperature sensor together, or F, to just use the floor temperature sensor installed inside your heated floor. In this case, select F and press Next to move to the next menu. Menu 2 is the unit switching variance, which is set by default at 1 degree. This determines how often you want your unit switching on and off when maintaining the floor temperature. When set at 1 degree, it means the elements will switch on when the floor temperature falls half a degree below the desired temperature and turn off when it gets half a degree over your desired temperature. You can increase this variance in temperature up to 10 degrees. In this case, however, we will leave it at the default temperature variance of 1 degree. Press Next to move to the next menu. Menu 3 is used to calibrate the unit's air temperature thermometer. Simply use the up or down arrows to calibrate the unit's thermometer up or down. Since we are only using the underfloor temperature sensor, we will leave this at 0 degrees difference and press Next to move to the next menu. Menus 4, 5, and 6 may not be available for programming depending on your unit's installation, which means the next option will be menu 7, which is used to change between Celsius and Fahrenheit. In this case, we will select C for Celsius and press Next to move to the next menu. Menu 8 is used to adjust the clock between 12 and 24-hour format. 24-hour format is the default option, but in this case we will change it to 12-hour format by selecting 12 and pressing Next to move to the next menu. Menu 9 is used to turn on frost protection. When this option is turned on, your unit will not allow the floors to fall below 5 degrees Celsius. This is handy in locations where the floor temperature can fall below freezing. In this case, however, we will switch it off, and then press Next to move to the next menu. Menu 10 is related to programming the timer, and allows you to select between two programming options to save time when setting the timer. Option 1 is called 5 plus 2 day mode, which will allow you to program the unit's switch on and switch off times just once, and they will be applied across the whole week, from Monday to Friday, with separate times to be programmed for the 2 days of Saturday and Sunday. Option 2 is called 7 day mode, which will allow you to set the switch on and switch off times for just 1 day, and they will be applied across the entire week, from Monday right through to Sunday. In this case, we will use option 2, which means we will be given the option to set the switch on and switch off times for 1 day, and all other days of the week will use these exact same times. With option 2 selected, you can either press next to go back to the beginning, which is menu 1, or if you're satisfied with the changes you have made, press done. The unit will now show that it has switched off. Setting the time and day. To set the time and day, press power if the unit is switched off, and then simply press the clock. Use the up or down arrows to find the current time, in this case 10 o'clock in the morning, and then press the next button. Now select the day of the week on the top of the screen by using the up or down arrows. In this case we will select Saturday, then press done. The time and day have now been set. Setting the 7-day on-off timer. This will allow us to use either 7-day mode, where we enter 1 day's times and those times will be applied across the whole week, or we can set each day's on and off times individually. To begin, turn on the unit by pressing power, then press schedule. Your current day of the week will start flashing on the top of the screen. At this point, you can either use the down arrow to choose the day of the week that you wish to program, or you can simply use 7-day mode by pressing the All Days button. In this case, we will use 7-day mode first by pressing the All Days button. You will see all of the days of the week flashing on the top of the display. Then press Next. The house symbol with a number 1 and a person inside will show at the top of the display. This is your floor's morning switch on time. Use the up or down arrow to select what time you would like your floors to warm up. In this case, we will choose 6:30 in the morning. Then press next to move onto your desired floor temperature. In this case, we will choose 23 degrees. Then press next. The house symbol displaying the number 2 and a person leaving will show at the top of the display. This is your floor's morning switch off time, whereby your floors will cool down again to their minimum or economy mode temperatures. In this case, we will have the floors turn off at 10 o'clock in the morning. Then press next to select your minimum or economy mode temperature. In this case, 14 degrees. Then press next. The house symbol displaying the number 3 and a person returning will show at the top of the display. This is your floor's evening switch on time. Like before, select your switch on time, in this case 5 o'clock in the evening, and press next. Then once more select your desired floor temperature, in this case 23 degrees, and press next. The house symbol displaying the number 4 with a person inside will show at the top of the display. This is your floor's final switch off time for the night. Select your desired switch off time, in this case 10 o'clock at night, and press next. Then select your desired minimum or economy temperature for the night. In this case we will choose 14 degrees. Then press done. All of the days of the week have now been set with those switch on and switch off times. If you wish to have different switch on times for different days, you can do so by pressing schedule again. Then use the down arrow to choose the day you wish to modify. For example, in this case, we will change the switch on times for Sunday so that the floors turn on later. To do so, select Sunday and press next. From here, you can simply replicate the previous instructions to select your times and temperatures for this individual day, and when complete, press done. The timer has now been set and the auto symbol is displayed. Selecting manual mode. If you wish to stop using the automated timer, you can select manual mode. To do so, press the mode button. The hand symbol will appear. Now, the unit will maintain whatever temperature you select. To choose a temperature, press the temperature on the display and use the up or down arrows. In this case, we will choose 20 degrees and press Done. To go back to the automatic schedule, press the Mode button, temporarily overriding the automatic temperatures. If you wish to temporarily force the unit to warm up or cool down at any given moment, simply press the temperature shown on the display. Then choose your desired new temperature and press Done. The override symbol will display and the unit will stay this way until you either press the Run Schedule button or until the next scheduled switch on or switch off event occurs in the unit's timer. Using Holiday Mode. Holiday mode means the unit will turn off for up to 99 days, only turning on if the temperature falls low enough to activate frost protection if you have frost protection turned on. To put the unit in holiday mode, press the holiday button, select the number of days you'll be away, in this case 5, and press Done. The unit is now in holiday mode and will display the number of days remaining at the top of the display. To turn off holiday mode early, press Holiday, adjust the number of days back down to 0, and press Done. Locking the keypad. To lock the keypad, press and hold the top left of the display for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, you will see the padlock symbol appear, and the unit will become unresponsive. To unlock the keypad, press and hold the top left of the screen again for 5 seconds. The padlock symbol will disappear. Changing the battery. To change the battery on the thermostat, use a small flat-headed screwdriver to pry the unit away from its base in 2 places below the unit. Then, turn the unit over and remove the ribbon connector for easier access. Gently pry the old battery out and replace it with a new one. The unit uses a CR1220 3-volt battery. When the new battery is in place, reconnect the cable and clip the unit back into place. Resetting the unit to its factory settings. To reset the unit to its factory settings, turn off the thermostat by pressing the power button. Then, press and hold off in the center of the display for 5 seconds. The unit has now been completely reset.